My name is Bree Winnegaw. I'm third in my class, and I go to Lance Cruz High School. I'm planning to go to U of M, and I'm undecided in what I will pursue. Well, it's academically, in my opinion, one of the best schools in Michigan, and I really like the campus.
We are at Lance Cruz High School. My name is Caitlin Cornwell. I am one of the valedictorians here with a GPA of 4.13. I'm planning on going to the University of Michigan, the Ann Arbor campus, with a math major. My interest in math was sparked from my teachers and the problem-solving skills that are required because I feel like that's a strong suit of mine.
My name is Katie Lindstrom. I'm valedictorian of my senior class. I have a 4.013 GPA, and I go to Lance Cruz High School. I'll be going to the University of Michigan. I'll be going into chemical engineering right now. I went to the MST Center for Math, Science, and Technology, and they really give you a good basis of math and science to go off of, and I decided that I want to pursue that in college as well.
My name's Leanna. I'm ranked fourth in our class. I'm the salutatorian, and I have a GPA of 3.975. Next year, I plan to go to Ferris State University to pursue pharmacy. I became interested in the program because I really like chemistry, and pharmacy involves a lot of chemistry, and I also would be able to love to help people, and it's somewhat in the medical field.
I would say that my most difficult class is probably my AP Chemistry class at PennCal.
My most challenging class has been AP Chemistry just because of the workload. You have to take a lot more time to study than any other class I've ever taken before. But once you get used to that, it really is a great class to get you ready for college.
Most difficult and challenging class was my AP Physics class in junior year. The teacher was definitely more fast-paced than I had been used to in other science classes, and I definitely learned that sometimes you have to teach yourself in high school, that you can't always be relying on the teacher or the things presented to you, that sometimes you actually have to take it home and look it over, and that's how you be successful in classes like that.
My most challenging class has probably been my English classes because they require outside-the-box thinking and not everything is black and white with your answers.
I played tennis for the first 3 years of high school, and I'm in National Honor Society.
Freshman year I played basketball, then I joined track, which I did for 2 years, and I did cross-country for 2 years. I also, my senior year, I was elected as a secretary for the National Honor Society, and I was also involved in Link Crew.
Outside of school, I have played tennis for 4 years. I've been on varsity all 4 years. I've also been involved with band pretty heavily. I've been in the Wind Symphony for 3 years and have been section leader.
My extracurricular activities have been the Lance Cruz Marching Band. I was drum major for 2 years, and so that's a really great position to be in. You conduct the band, you handle a lot of paperwork behind the scenes, but it's a really like fulfilling experience, I think. So, and before that I marched with the band for 2 years, so that took up a lot of time.
Well, in Link Crew there was a lot of leadership opportunities. I feel I was able to really help some incoming freshmen and give them good advice and make them feel more comfortable. Also in the National Honor Society, I was able to do a lot of leadership. We came up with a lot of new activities and ways to get people involved in the community.
Some opportunities to show my leadership skills have mainly been with band, being section leader. It's my job to mentor incoming freshmen and basically act as a leader for everybody to get the job done.
Opportunities for leadership have definitely been in the marching band with my drum major position. It was definitely, we act as a pathway between the directors and the students. So the directors relay information to us and we project it out to the students. And not only do we act as workers, well, kind of workers, for the directors, but we're also a big motivator for the marchers and for the band together. So we control the attitude of the rehearsal, how things are going to go, because we kind of run the rehearsal with the directors behind us. So
I do a lot of community service and things like that that allow me to be in the leadership position. I have two jobs, so I sometimes work with new employees. So
my favorite teacher was Mrs. Opaleski, just because she was so relaxed and helpful, but she was always there to support us, and I really enjoyed English and writing, so that was a great class.
My favorite class has probably been physics with Mr. Van Wingerden, because it pushed me to do my best all the time and taught me what I was actually capable of.
My favorite teacher was Mrs. Duncan from the Pink House Center. She was my AP Calc and Pre-Calc teacher. She had a really great way of bringing the class to life.
I think that I am a valedictorian and successful because of my work habits and the support of my peers and family.
I think I've been successful in high school because I always set goals for myself and I work hard at them. I take a lot of time out of my day to study and make sure that I get my schoolwork done, but then I also get involved in other school activities, which has helped me meet people and given me lots of opportunities.
I think that I'm successful because I'm a persevering type of person, and one of my biggest strengths is that I see the value in being and doing the best in everything that I try to do. I just want to be my best person and my best student, and so I can be proud of myself.
I was so successful because of the support of my family, I think. My parents are the type of people to be like, they're always at my band events. They were always at every football game watching the marching band perform, which I was involved in. And they're always pushing me to do my best. And my mom asked me all the time, was that the best you could do? And if it was, that's what she would be happy with. Really involved in Relay for Life for the past 4 years. And I have my own team with my partner, Nick Vizanko. We're both captains for a team, and so we've spent a lot of hours on that. And I think our team have raised about maybe more than $1,000 each year, and that goes directly towards cancer research.
I enjoy doing community service with my grandma. She's very involved with the Kiwanis Club of Clinton Township, so I do a lot of stuff with them, especially around Thanksgiving and Christmas and things like that. I've done Relay for Life for like 5 years now. That's one of my favorite things to do.
Well, I did math tutoring for a year, which I just tutored a 7th grade math student and helped him get his grade up. I also helped out at my little brother's middle school. They do forensics and plays, and so I was kind of behind the scenes helping there.
For community service, I mostly have tutored students, and I really enjoy that because I just think that education is very important. And when students accomplish things academically, it gives them a new confidence. I've also helped with like blood drives and soup kitchens and things like that.
I think my whole family has guided me a lot. I look up to my parents and my older brother. He's a good role model for me, and my grandparents too.
I would definitely say my parents. They are always there to support me. They make things in my life easier so that I can focus more on school and things that are important.
My mentor is probably my teachers or my parents and friends, because they're just always available to teach me like life lessons and how to do my best, and there to support me.
Probably my parents. I couldn't count the number of times that I've come to my mom with problems, if it were, you know, personal or even school related. Like, we spend time around the dinner table every night talking about my school day and like everything. If it was a test or if it was my friends bothering me or just something even really funny happened. I think I'm gonna miss most about high school is being around my friends every day.
I think that I will miss my friends in high school and some of the relationships that I've formed with teachers.
The things I'll miss about high school are just being able to walk down the hallways and know everyone, and it's kind of comforting, and also the classes, because you really get to know everyone in your classes, and in college it's a little bit more removed.
I guess what I'll miss about high school is all the people that I've met along the way. My best high school memory is probably spending time on the tennis team. We do a lot of all-day tournaments, so it was fun hanging out with all the girls there. And Relay for Life is a 24-hour event, so I had a lot of fun there, too.
One of my favorite memories was track season, just because when I was a freshman and a sophomore, I got to meet a lot of older kids, and I got to meet people from different schools, and we just had a lot of fun.
My best high school memory would probably just be the everyday experiences in high school, along with the different opportunities presented, such as like the boat regatta and football games.
My best high school memory was when I conducted state finals for band at Ford Field. We go down there every year to Detroit, and it's this big competition between the best 12 bands of the state, and we won second place. And it was really an amazing feeling conducting for the last time in that atmosphere, and it was a really proud moment.
For incoming freshmen, I would advise them to not get overwhelmed and to take things step by step. Try not to get involved with drama and work hard, because there will be a big payoff in the end.
Advice for the incoming freshmen, I would say to start off your academic career strong. Form good study habits early, because if you get good grades from an early start, that will set you up to get into a good college and hopefully get a scholarship from that college too.
I would say not to get overwhelmed by everything. The school appears very big at first, but it gets a lot smaller, and to manage their time so that they can balance, you know, personal life and schoolwork at the same time.
Advice for incoming freshmen would definitely is to think of where you want to be when you're a senior. It's hard to think when you're just coming into high school that your choices and what you do and what classes you take are going to affect the person that you are now. But you need to consider how hard you work now is going to propel you to be more successful in your future. So every decision and every opportunity that you take now is going to impact you later.